America won't reject abortion until America sees abortion.
A controversial ad on the most high-profile stage of all, and the first time around could be just the beginning.
This local political ad opposing abortion is making national news. Some of you are asking why WLWT and other stations broadcast it, and if there are any limits on explicit political speech. So we got you answers today from an expert.
The dog is funnier than the Vader, kid.
What did you think was the funniest Super Bowl ad? The Volkswagen puppy?
Hi, can I get my CRV brought up, please?
The return of Ferris Bueller? Probably not. This one.
Boehner has blood on his hands.
It was run by David Lewis, who's challenging House Speaker John Boehner in Ohio's March 6th GOP primary. We broadcast Lewis's campaign ad yesterday, but we're not showing you the most disturbing images now. The 26-year-old Batavia father conceded to me he probably won't win in the 8th district. But Lewis claims Boehner has supported budgets that include funding for Planned Parenthood. So,
one thing I can do as a federal candidate is to show, literally show pictures of the mangled bodies of babies murdered by abortion on television stations with FCC licenses.
Another anti-abortion activist, Randall Terry, who's opposing President Obama nationwide as a Democrat, has also run explicit campaign ads. And today, a local attorney, nationally known for defending hustler owner Larry Flint in First Amendment cases, told me according to law, TV stations cannot limit the political speech of legitimate candidates.
And if it's offensive and it's a problem, the First Amendment was there to protect offensive speech. And so if somebody doesn't like it, that's not simply enough.
So are there no limits at all? I mean, if something that was political would otherwise be considered obscene, what about that?
It may then have to be controlled by, you know, those special hours that have been set aside, that it's not appropriate for children and that should be played in that hours of 12 to 6 a.m.
But in this case, the Federal Communications Commission ruled the images of aborted fetuses are not indecent political speech. And we did ask John Boehner's office about all this, and they told us the speaker's pro-life record is well known and that he's been endorsed by Ohio Right to Life.